Welcome to the Eleusinia Mushroom Cultivation Course Part 1. If you're joining us for a refresher after doing this class in person at the retreat, welcome. Great to see you again. If you're joining us for the first time, welcome and great to meet you. For those not familiar, Eleusinia Retreats is a retreat dedicated to the practice of using psilocybin in pain management. That is a rather complicated subject, so I won't really cover it too much here. Maybe we will talk more about the retreat itself or my personal experience with psilocybin and pain management in subsequent videos. The retreat includes a mushroom cultivation course, and this series focuses on reviewing the methods covered in that course. It's here to help any of our guests who might need a refresher on the details after doing the course in person, and for anyone out there looking to incorporate psilocybin into their pain management routine. Growing mushrooms is a bit complicated, and I'm sure even the most diligent note taker is going to need at least a little help after the in-person class. Learning how to grow your own medication while dealing with the brain fog and anxiety that come with chronic pain isn't easy either, so I selected the most stress-free, low-maintenance, and error-proof method possible. If you joined us for the retreat, you received a package with all the tools needed to complete each step of this process. But don't worry if you don't have the package. It's made up of all household items that are easy to source and assemble. So let's get started. Mushrooms are not plants, so don't worry if you have a brown thumb. I've never been great with plants, and look at me now. Quick nerd fact, mushrooms have more in common with animals than they have with plants. They breathe oxygen and exhale carbon dioxide, and they don't require sun to produce energy. The type of mushroom that we'll be focusing on is Psilocybin cubensis. And this first section will be focused on understanding how these mushrooms grow in the wild. If you understand their natural life cycle, then it makes it much easier to understand the logic behind the actual steps in the cultivation process. I will refer back to these concepts as we progress through the course. These mushrooms are coprophyllous. This is a fancy term meaning that they grow on poop. But relax, we will not be using any actual poop in the cultivation process. But poop is a very important part of their natural life cycle, so we will cover the concept in this section. Most gourmet species grow on decomposing wood, not poop. This is one reason why there are some key differences in the cultivation process for the gourmet mushrooms versus the medicinals. Most wood-loving gourmets grow on the vertical surfaces, while poop-loving medicinals grow on flat surfaces. These mushrooms start their life cycles when spores are released into the air and land on the grass. When a cow eats the grass, the spores pass through the digestive system and end up deposited in a cow patty. The spores germinate in the patty and begin to grow into mycelium. We'll refer to this as the colonizing stage. After the mycelium has consumed all the available nutrients and the cow patty has started to dry out, mushrooms appear and open their caps to drop spores and start the cycle again. We'll refer to this part of the process as the fruiting stage. And for the record, this cartoon is not to scale. Mycelium will continue to grow pretty much indefinitely as long as there is food available, and will not fruit as long as it's still in the colonizing stage. Many impatient newbies ruin their hard work trying to get a colony to fruit while at the wrong point in the process. Yeah, I get that the whole process sounds pretty gross. The good news is that we will not be actually using any manure at any point in any of the following steps. We're going to use a technique called grain to bulk. This method is popular with a lot of commercial mushroom farmers and has been the easiest and lowest maintenance option for me. Here's a quick overview. With the grain to bulk method, the mycelium is started in a sealed mason jar of cooked grain. It grows in a safe, sterilized, isolated environment until fully colonized. Then we mix the colonized grain with a spongy, well-hydrated substrate. We then set it in a sealed plastic bin to completely finish digesting the grain and finish covering the substrate. The mushrooms will emerge soon after the colony runs out of food to consume. But all this we will cover in detail in the subsequent videos. Please subscribe if you want to keep up with the new videos, and until next time.